Hey there. I wanted to make this video to talk with you. I'm not sure when I'm gonna upload. I have ideas for videos, but I've just been like so swamped. I'm working on music right now. That's like my main focus, to get my album done. And then I have some things I gotta do for the album, like, you know, a couple videos and stuff, and very special kind of project for the album upon release that I want to get done, so I'm going to focus on that too. I had a lot of goals in mind, but those goals just have all fallen through. So I'm thinking I'll scrap those goals to make room for the goals of my album. Yeah, things have changed for me on YouTube. I'm probably not going to upload when I'm working on music, at least this year, because that has just been taking up a lot of my time. I haven't really had the means to record usual videos like I always used to do. Things have changed. I have gotta change a lot of things to make room for my new goals. But in the meantime, I guess I'll give you an update of my vinyl collection. Yeah, this is something I can do for sure. First, we have King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard Silver Cord. I got this one last week. This is the first vinyl I got, and I showed you that I got it. Very good album. Definitely different from the others. I had meant to get Petro Dragonic Apocalypse as well, but you know, I just haven't had the money for some time. And I'll get the new album at some point. I don't know when. Yeah, this is very good. It's the pink one, the Crystal Ball edition. This is what it's called. You guys should be satisfied for a while with this content, I hope. Be jerking off in your room. The fact that Sweet Aaron uploaded their content for you. Because I'm that good. I'm good. I turn you guys on, don't I? Yes. And the extended mix. And it's got some really nice glare to it too. I love that. Look at that. It's a gatefold. Impressive. Very nice. And next is MGT Loss of Life. MGMT Loss of Life. This album was really good, actually. I got into it again because I kind of forgot how it sounded, but I remember enjoying it. This is a very basic one. Nothing special here, but. And it's just a standard black vinyl, which I thought would be better because look at the album cover. Next is Metallica, Master of Puppets. This is a very good album. Like it's one, but I do prefer the sound of Ride the Lightning for sure. Nice orange vinyl. I haven't actually heard this album for a while. I should listen to it again. I've also been doing mostly well. I think I have anxiety. I haven't had the means to actually get diagnosed with anxiety, but I had a really bad bout of anxiety recently for a good few days at least, like nonstop, and now I'm taking supplements to curb that. Next is 46 Short Specimen. This is one I saw at a record store, and I like, that's really interesting, so I got it. This one is just another standard black vinyl record. I haven't really listened to this one yet, but you know, sounds pretty good from what I've heard. And a lyric sheet. I wonder if they're like a local band from Minnesota. Frankie Eldorado, self-titled album. This guy looks like your uncle's music project. I listened to this one maybe once. It was fine. Didn't sound bad. Ooh, sleeve cover is just another standard black vinyl. I haven't really revisited it since. Next is 21 Pilots Clancy. God, this album is so good. So fucking good. Let's see which one this is. Oh, it's the dual black and white version. I'm gonna get the CD at some point because I'm sure that has some artwork that I haven't seen yet. And I love Trump Pilots so much. I want to collect every single record they have out. Maybe even some bootleg versions of Regional Best Myself titled. God, you know? And, another version of Clancy. Which is the Walmart edition. Look at that. It didn't do so good on this side, but this side, look at this shit. Which is fine, I guess. It was the only one my local Walmart had, so, you know, I wasn't just gonna let it sit there. This is album of the year for me, at least. From Ashes to New of the Future. Now, I haven't actually listened to this one yet, but I got it because it was $5, it was on sale. And sometimes that's all you need to be convinced. I feel like I've heard of this band, or should have heard of this band. The record is just a standard black vinyl, again, of course. I don't know, I think this is like an emo band, post-hardcore. They look like they used to be emo kids, for sure. Senses fail, if there's light, it will find you. I have heard of this band, actually. I like the record too. Oh, and check out the gatefold. Really cool. And the skeleton on the cover has been their mascot since it looks like I look at their social media. Looks like it. Weird one coming up. Primus, the Desaturating Seven. This is their latest full-length studio. Of course they have put up music since. But this is their latest LP. This is a great album. This album goes hard as fuck. And it shows that they still have it, but they want to put out less music since there's only 7 songs on this album. Just my observation, anyways. King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard, KGLW. Both KG and LW. 2LP. KG, LW. I like the jacket for it. I like the how it feels. And King Gizzard Cordis. This album's really good too. This is the gold dipped edition or whatever. I forgot what it was exactly. Next we have Tools Lateralis. I was going to get Fear Inoculum, but I have not had the money to get that mass monster of an album. I think this is side A and side B. I'm not sure. They're not marked at all. I fantastic fucking album. Can't even begin to tell you how much this album is, how fantastic this fucking album is. And the last few. David Bowie's "'Tis a Pity She Was a Whore" and "Sewer in a Season of Crime," the 2014 versions. Now, I'm a big David Bowie fan, and yeah, I fucking missed him after he died, you know. And his last album was fantastic. And I tracked down this 10-inch vinyl of the original versions of "'Tis a Pity She Was a Whore" and "Sewer in a Season of Crime." It's so cute and it's so flat. I'm gonna throw it like a frisbee. And the lyrics are in the back, actually. Very nice. This was never officially released to streaming, which I don't know why. Some band called The Godfathers, Love Is Dead, Valentine's Day Massacre Mix. It came with the David Bowie record. I'm not sure what it is. Haven't really listened to it yet. Just a standard black vinyl. Looks like there's like two or three songs total on this thing. I'll check it out at some point. And the seller actually included a full-length album too, called Tom Robinson Sector 27. Sounds like new wave from what I heard. Just another black vinyl. I don't know. That's it. Yeah, I'll definitely get to finishing my album, and I'll do the thing I gotta do, and then you'll be hearing from me. Peace out. See y'all.